Okay, so today I am going to discuss a very important topic for that Ayurveda students, especially that undergraduate students. That is Vrana Shodha. Vrana Shodha is maybe can be correlated with that inflammations in modern surgical practice. Okay, so here the topic is means we discuss the things which is described in our Ayurvedic test. And how can we understand it on the parameters of that modern surgical? So first, give the overview of presentation. We have that reference definitions. What are the type of that Vrana Shodha? What are the stages? Their clinical features and the principle of the management. So in Ayurvedic, if we talk about the surgery in Ayurveda, so the main textual reference is then that's Shusha Sanhita. So that is the most important and most trusted, most ancient, and most practical textual things which you could find in for Ayurvedic literatures. That is the Shusha Sanhita. So this it can be considered that the Shusha Sanhita is the most ancient literature available for the surgical management of the diseases. So in the Sutrasthan, the chapter number 17, this is mentioned, and in Charak Charak also mentioned that Savatthu Shodha in the Chikitsa 12. Okay, so now we are going to discuss this. That Shodha. So here the definition of that mention is Shusha Sanhita. Soap samutthanam granthi vidrdhi alachi parvatyah prayed vyadayo abhita anek akritya tayer vilakshana prthu kritita samo visamo va tvam sansthai dosh sanghataha शरीर एक देशो स्थिते शोभा इति उच्यते मीन्स सो आचार्य शुश्रुता स्टार्टिंग द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ शोथ अलोंग विद सम अदर स्मॉल डिजीजेस ही सेज दैट द वेरियस डिसऑर्डर्स लाइक ग्रंथि विद्रति एलर्जी which are the क्षुद्र रोग सो दैट हैव द लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ द शोथ along with these diseases means that granthi vidrati allergy may also have present with a small amount of the shodha but the what here we are discussing the vrana shodha that is the different from this that it spreads from the nodules, it's unlikely from these granthi with the energy, the soap is spreading. It has the nodular shape, may be equal or unequal, means maybe equally spread or maybe unevenly spread. It may be seated in the twasha or may go deep to the manjadhatu. And with the vitiation of that doshas, it may present in a single, yeah, it may be the when it is limited to the small part of the body, then it is called a shodha. So here we are discussing the shodha which is limited to the small part of the body, not spreading to whole body. When it is spread to whole body, then that is called Sarvang Shodha. That is different things. So Sarvang Shodha may be that may call as the in modern science that we call this anasarca, generalized swelling. But we calling the Vrana Shodha inflammation, then we call that development the abscess of the inflammation. This is the inflammation. Okay, so inflammation is the limited part. It always limit to a particular body part. It's not spreading to whole body. Okay, so here is the swelling, which is limited to a small part of the body, and which is having little difference from the allergy granthidi and vidati. How it is different? That it spreads in the nodular side, maybe equal sum of visumum is unequal or unequal size, and may go little deep from skin to the mansa dhatu itself. Okay, and it is always limited to the one particular part of body. So this is the definition of the shotha. So there is some other term along with the sofa, that is abhighata shotha, and means the soft is developed due to the abhighata, means that inflammation develops after the trauma or the injury, any kind of the injury, that may be the mechanical injury, that may be the chemical injury, any kind of the injury, maybe the any toxins which causing the inflammation. So that is comes under the abhighata shofa. And other term that sarvanga shofa, which is generalized swelling, the anasarka, and when complete body is having the swelling. So what we are discussing now, that is the inflammations. So in Ayurveda there is the six type of the shotha is there. So according to the involved dosha. So here because Acharya Shushruta always considered rakta is also the fourth dosha. You know, in Ayurveda when we talk about the dosha, there is three dosha, vata, pitta, kapha. But in surgical practice in Shushruta, he always considered blood also as a independent dosha. So he is also considered the rakta shonita as a chaturtha dosha. So here on the basis of this dosha, vataja, pithaja, kaphaja, and shonitaja, and saninpataja, means all above four, and one agantu shotha, when there is any external factors which is behind the cause of that shotha. So that may be the any kind of the injury, that may be the any kind of that mechanical injury, any chemical injury, or any kind of that injury. So here we discuss one by one. Every shotha has its characteristic features, which are mostly depend on the characteristics of that involved dosha. So that as we know, that there is the difference in the colors, and there is difference in the pain, character of the pain also, and different maybe the different of the spread, maybe the difference in the presentation. So here we see along with the involvement dosha as the vataja. So vataja dosha, he tatra vata sofa krishnu aruno va parusho mrdu an avasthita stodasya vedana visheshu hamti. Here we means that differentiation is done on the classification is done on the basis of the involved dosha, and the characteristic of the particular dosha are completely depend on the which is the prominent dosha involved in that condition. So vata has its characteristic the color, which is krishna aruno. Parusho means there is a roughness, if that is characteristic of vata. Mrdu, and there is the softness, mrdu means that softness, anu avasthita stodas vedana bhavam, vedana visheshu means the characteristic pain that is involved in the vata dosa, that is tod, that is pricking, needle pricking like pain. So the vata dosa, if any dosha has prominence of the vata, then it must have the these characteristic features that has the aruna and krishna color. It may be the rough, it may be the soft. Okay, and there is different with the rough and soft. Rough means that the surface is rough. Okay, and softness means that on the palpation you feel that soft, the swelling is soft, not hard. Okay, and don't confuse from that parush and mrdu. Okay, parush means that is the surface is not smooth, it is rough surface, but the swelling is soft. Okay, and anavasthita todastha bhavanti means there is the tod type of the pain is there. I say when we next the pitta shofa, it has the colors, the you know the pitta is always color the yellow, causing the yellow discolorations. So color is the yellow, and it is also mrdu. Sarato means there is maybe increased that blood circulation in that area. So sarato, and sigra anusaryo osadayascha vedana visheshyo. So this as the characteristic of pitta is the flaring, means fast spreading. So this pitta shofa is sigra anusaryo, means is very fast spreading and has the osha type of that pain. Todh osh. Okay. Vedana visheshyo. So that osh means when the pain is means that anything is that burning sensation, by feeling burning sensation when the some fire is near. Okay, it not direct burning that body, but when the fire is near of that body, so what are the warmness feeling, that is the that kind of the pain is called osh pains. So that in and the next kaphaji, that has the features sleshma shavatru pandu kathina snigdha sito snigdho manda anusari kandvadayascha vedana visheshyo. So here the color is white, pandu color. Okay, sleshma shavatru has the color pandu, any pallor color. It is hard, kathin, snigdha, smooth, sheet, cold, and snigdha mandha anusari means that's inflammation, which is the pallor in color, hard, cold, and slow spreading, and always has the kandvadayascha vedana visheshyo, means that here the itching is the important features. Okay, so here we can differentiate the color. Vata has the krishna aruna karana, pitta has yellow color, and the kapha has pandu color, and the surface is in vata is parusha, pitta is in the madhu, and kapha is in the there is the kathin and snigdha and the cold. Okay, so you can differentiate on the palpation and the inspection of these on the basis of palpation and inspection. You can differentiate these what is the main involver dosha in that particular rakta shotha, the inflammation. So that kapha has rakta has almost all the features similar to the pitta, and in the sannipata where you have the mixed characteristic all this all in all the involved dosha, then that is sannipata. And in the agantuk shows also has most because whenever you get any person get injured or any kind of that injury, that may aggravate vitiate the rakta as well as the pitta. So the agantuk shot alve also has the features of that just like the pitta. So pitta rakta lakshana, pitta and rakta agantuk hetuha avbhasha. So that agantuk shot also has the features of that just like pitta and rakta, similar to pitta and rakta. So here we are having the features of that the sofa according to that different involve doshas, predominant doshas. Also has involved all the doshas, but which one is dominant, that may present its features. So there are the three stages in the dosha. Every dosha have three stages. First amavastha, second pachyamanavastha, and third is the parpavastha. So first we discuss that characteristic features of the amavastha. So in amavastha, that Acharya Sushruta described, tatra man doshmatah tvak samartah sit shokatah sthairyam manda vednatah alap shokatah cha ama dachanam udishtam, means when the soul is in amavastha, then it must have man doshmata, means it is not very hot. Usmata mand means it is warm, that swelling will be warm, not hot. The color is just like the skin. Tuk samarnata seet softa, that swelling is cold. स्थैर्यम मंद वेतनता. स्थैर्यम मीन्स दैट इज देर इज दैट 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 स्वेलिंग इज नॉट स्प्रेडिंग वेरी मच. ओके इट इज स्टेबल. एंड मंद वेता द पेन इज वेरी मिनिमल. अल्प शोफता च आम लक्षण एंड द स्वेलिंग इज मिनिमल नॉट वेरी मच. ओके सो हियर ऑल द थिंग्स आर द मिनिमल. Any characteristic is not aggravated very much, so that is the amavastha means the primitive stage, initial stage. Is there any shotha? When is the initial stage? It has the warmness. The color is not very well differentiated, so that color is the same as the skin color. It is cold and stable and having the minimal pain. Next is say this is the pachyamanavastha and this is the most important stage and the most difficult stage also for the patients because there is so much features are there, so many types of the pain is there. So characteristic of pain described on the that may depends on the involved dosha. Different kinds of that some aggravation is there, some type of pain is not there. Maybe all the characteristic feel, all this type of the pain which are described here may not available there. That may depends on that which in those is involved. So here that he described the characteristic of pain. Suchi bhirev nishtudhate hai means the pain is just like someone pricking the needles. Dashate pipidikabhi means ants are biting. Ants are biting. Tabhischa sansarpayati chidati ushastrena, and that ants are biting and they are moving on that. The patient has feeling that ants are moving on their his body, his or her body surface. Chidati ushastrena, any is making incision by any kind of that that shastra, any means injury, any sharp objects. Vidyate means any patient, anybody is pricking, anybody is pricking or that making incision on that body. And the tadyate dandena, just like a beating by that rods. Pidyate palina, and just like had patient feel like somebody is beating by hands and somebody is strangulating him and somebody is burning. Dahyate pachyate uch agnicharabhyam, cauterization, somebody is pouring that fire or some alkali or some acids on that and the os chos paridah shagun. So there are three type of the burning sensation are there. Os chos paridah, so everybody has characteristic. Os means somebody is just directly burning. Okay, chos means feeling the burning sensation but the fire is near. And paridah means patient is feeling that he is in between that fire, means the fire is all around and patient is feeling it. So there is three different kind of burning sensation. Patient may be feel any kind of this or all may be this. And vrischik vidhyu cha sthan sayan, vrischik vidhyu, and the pain may be just like the scorpion bite. And sthan asana shailisu na shanti bhavati means this is the characteristic feature that patient have not feeling well in any kind of situation, either he is sitting or lying. It means in any position patient is not getting relief from that pain. And along with this patient may have atmat vastri vatast sopo bhavanti, means that that the soap, that swelling is so much tense, just like any vasti filled with the water. Okay, you know, if you are Ayurvedic student, you know the basti, that is the bladder. Okay, so if the bladder is full by, you can understand just like, and that swelling is filled just like that any balloon is filled with the water. Okay, so it means the swelling is so much tense. Talk by varnium here that color of the skin is changed by varnium. Discoloration is there. So how he brought there. ज्वर दाह पिपाशा भक्त अरुचि पश्चिमालिंग. Gangam along with this Tugavarnam. Soth is when the soth is growing in size, along with this patient may have jara, daha, pipasa means patient may have fever, burning sensation, thirsty, and bhakt aruchi means anorexia. Okay, so these are the features of the Pachyamana Lingam. These are that all features of the Pachyamana Avastha of the Shofa. So any patient can feel all these characteristic features, but it depends on the which dose is involved. So if what is involved, then the pain of that that initial pain, the suchi may mistate hai tasate vedika, these may be the peculiar features. And there is a chiddate chiddati ushastren bhedati ushakti, these may be the peculiar of the vata. And when the pitta is involved, then patient have the peculiar features as dacha dahiti pachati agni charabhyam oshosh paridaha, these may be the peculiar features. Okay, when the cough is important feature, then pain may be the not important features. Then adhmat basti may be the hardness of the basti feeling, that may be the important leading features, and that increasing size, that may be the leading features. Okay, so the Pachyamana Avastha, all three doses are involved, but depends on that which dose is most dominant. All these characteristics feature may not present. Okay, so that features which are depending on the involved dosha, that may be the leading features of that shrotha. So next stage is the Pakva Avastha. So after Pachyamana Avastha, this is the Pakva Avastha. Okay, so here we see that after the Pachyamana Avastha, that pain is subsided a little bit. Okay, means that now the disease is settled and the suppuration is happening. That inflammation is get suppurated. So this is the stage of the suppuration, where there is the characteristic features of this Pakva Avastha, that vedono ko shanti hai panduta alap sukta vali pradurbhava tuk pariputanam nimna darshanam anguliha upidete pratyutmanam vasta vidok sancharanam puyasya prapidya अनेक मंते चाओ पीड़ित है पूयश प्रपीड़त्या अनेक मंत मंते चाओ पीड़ित है मुहुर मुहस्तोदा कंडु उन्नता व्याधेर उपद्रव शांति भक्त अभिकांचा चपक पीड़ा. Okay, so these are the features where we see that the pain is reduced little bit. So in the condition of the shofa, the pain is most prominent feature of the Pachyamana Avastha. It is not in Amavastha and not in Pakva Avastha, because that suppuration is happened. So now that the features are that vedanup shanti, the pain is subsided little bit, not disappear, but it is subsided, means it reduced from that previous stage. Color become pandu, that redness become gone, and again the color become the pandu. Inflammation is progressed, it means that it goes into that suppuration stage. Alp sopta, that swelling is now, that swelling is not growing now, that is stopped. Vali sopta vali pradurbhava stok parputanam nimdarasnam anguliya upidet pratyutmanam. So features which we observe in any patient during that examination of the that palpation, that vali pradurbhav means there is a wrinkles in that skins are there. Wrinkles in the skin are vali pradurbhav in there, means when the body is stretched, there is swelling. Now when the swelling is reduced, so due to stretching is there, so there the wrinkles are developed in that skin, sutha part the wrinkles is present. And that nimna darshanam angulya upidetutana, means when we press by the fingers, our fingers just we press, there is the, and after when we relieve pressure, that pututana means there is we can say there is a one kind of that non-pitting edema. Okay, means when we in pitting edema, when we press by fingers, there is pit there, and slowly that pit become filled up. Here that non-pitting is when we press by the finger, there is the pit is formation. When we remove a finger, pratutpannam is it can it come again, that swelling is again become that that labeled, that pit become disappear. Vasta vibodak sancharanam uyasya prapidyat anekmante chavapidam. So here there is the vasta vibodak sancharanam uyas, that is the feature of that when we examine any swelling, so there is fluctuation test in there. Means when there is a swelling, when we there is a swelling, suppose this is swelling and we are examined with two fingers, when we press this finger one side, then the other side goes up, and when we press this side, this finger goes up, because that the fluid inside is pressing. When we press one side, so the complete fluid is displayed to other side, and it gives a pressure to the opposite side of finger in the directly the vertically, so that the when the press of one side, then other other side finger goes up, and when we press that side, this type of this side fingers goes up. Means there is the fluctuation test. You can find the fluctuation test positive in that pakva avastha, the shofa. So here we can say that that all the features of the sushupta describes that was very much practical. Okay, so that in the modern science also, when you examine any abscess filled with a pus cavity, you can find the exact features. Just like fluctuation is there. Okay, so and the muhur mustoda means there is again two the type of pain is there. That is continuous throbbing pain is there. Kandur ununta, there is the itching is there, and the severity of that disease looks reduced. Means vyadhar upadrav shanti. Patient feels little bit relief. Okay, so the patient may say that, oh, I'm little bit relieved, my disease is curing, but it's not. It's another stage which has the features are little bit less. The pain and the discomfort little bit less in compared to the pachyamana avastha, and the other features just like fevers and the anorexia that may continue. Okay, so here we see that now the suppuration is happened, and then that cavity is the soap is soap is filled with that abscess is there in any collection fluid collection, that is pus is there. So every sutra has to go in these three stages, depends on that what the treatment he or that patient got. If the patient got the treatment in the amavastha, then it may not progress into the pachyamanavastha. If the patient get correct treatment in the pachyamanavastha, then it may not go into the pakvavastha. Okay, and if the pakvavastha the treatment is not well in the pakvavastha, then there is maybe the some other complication which we discuss in the later slide. So here is the that importance of the knowledge of the stage of sutra. As Acharya Sushruta has mentioned one shloka that amam vipachyamanam cha samyakah pakvam cha yuvishkah janiyat sa bhavet vaidyah sesas taskrutya. Means a good surgeon always knows the difference between these three stages, because every stage has its peculiar management. Means amavastha has different management, pachyamana avastha has different management, pakva avastha has different management. So if any surgeon is not able to identify the stage of dosha, so he cannot give the correct treatment. So the importance of these stages, he said, if any surgeon is not knowing the correct stages of the sutra, then that person is not a good surgeon or a good doctor. He must be considered as that just a taskar, means just a smuggler, means which is not good in practice. So here you can understand that what are the important of these three stages. If any doctor is not able to identify, differentiate these three stages, then that means he or she is not a good doctor, good surgeon. So here it says that all the doshas are involved. means the three doshas, vata, pitta and kaphas. So Shrushta says without that I already discussed the differential type of dosha, but say always all three doshas should be there in the pakva avastha. The features may be depend on the predominant of any one dosh can be predominant, but always there is involvement of all three doshas. That's why he says vatatte nasti rujaha na pakaha pittatte nasti kaphas ch bhuya. Means if any sot is there, if vat is not there, so there will be no pain. Means wherever there is a pain, there must be vat. Na pakaha pittatte. Wherever there is a pak, there must be a pitta. Wherever there is a puya, that is pus, here must be involvement of the kapha. Tasmat samastan paripaka kale pachanti sokhastre dosha. Means and that's why any pakka sofa has all these characteristic features. Any pakka sofa has pain, any pakka sofa has pak, any pakka sofa has poi. That's why during the paka avastha of the sofa, all the three dosha must be involved. Okay, so here we discuss the principle of management, how should be management manage the pakka sofa. How to manage the sofa? That management depends on the stages of. He says seven upakrama. Okay, so that all upakrama are not required for every doshas, every sofa, every which management, which treatment you are going, you are choosing for any patient. That depends on the stage of the sofa. Which your sofa is in which stage? According to that, you have to choose that these type of the management. So he says there is the seven management. Adyo bimlapanam kuryar, dvitiye avsechanam, tritiye upanaha, tu chaturthi patan kriyaha, panchamam shodhanam kuryat, ropanam mishyateh, shastam ropanam mishyateh, ete krama vrnevo shubhoktah, saptam vaikratah. So there are seven stages of the management. First is the bimlapan, second avsechan, third upanaha, fourth patan kriya, fifth shodhana, sixth ropana, seventh vaikratapaha. So one by one we discuss what is bimlapan, what is the importance and what is the how it acts. So first is the bimlapana. Bimlapana is just the gentle massage of that part where the sota is just initiating. Means that bimlapana and avsechan, these are the two stitches which are very much effective in the amavastha. If you have the sota in the amavastha, then if you give the bimlapana and avsechan. Avsechan means rakta avsechan, means the bloodletting, rakta bloodletting. You have to take out the blood of that then the local area by the sirabed or the jalaku or the jalauka or the alabu saranga, any method you use to just let out the blood in that local area. So these two are very effective and very important for that amavastha. These may be not as much as effective in that pakva avastha. Okay, so that's why he mentioned in the first and second it as first and second bimlapan, just a gentle massage by at the site of that where the sota is presenting, is by the finger or by any bamboo stick. You just massaging in that part so that the doshas which are that accumulate in that part, that may get dissolved and spreads, so that may resolve that condition and the disease is not progress to the pachyamana avastha. Avsechan is also same, that because the whatever the disease progress, that all the doshas are come to that place by the blood only, and there is a dosha samurchana is there, and that particular part, if you are letting out that blood, so it is possible that all the VTH dosha present in that area are drained out by the with the blood, so that disease may be stopped and that condition only. So it will not progress. Next is the upanaha. Upanaha is that the wet fermentations. It's kind of the fermentation. Poultice is also the same. Means you, that may be the use some drugs or without drugs, that simple that that you know, ferment wet fermentation form of the wet fermentation is there. You can use the medicine or without medicine, and that part. So this is the this also acts the what is the possible mode of action of the upanaha. There is two types. First, if the dose in amavastha, then the, all that it will dissolve all the samprapti and all that those do samurchana, it get dissolved and those are separated and goes their ways. Means what is the avrud is marga avrud is relieved, so those can travel their normal direction, so there is no disease progression, it will subside it. And if it is not happened, means that those are so much progressed, so then the poor group are presents in that conditions, means it is not possible to return to the normal condition, then that pakva avastha, it reduces the duration of the pachimana avastha, which is very painful stage for the patient. So that it reduces the pachimana avastha and directly to the fermentation, that paka avastha comes very early, so it, that your soap is get ready for the shastra karma. Means that your abscess, if we talk in that modern science, any abscess is there, it is not ripened. So you can apply this by this upanaha, that abscess become ripe early. Okay, so that you can give the IND, incision and drainage, and you can treat that condition. So that upanaha helps in two ways. If your the sotha is in mandavastha, then it get early mandavastha, then it gets subsided and it gets dissolved. And if it is if your dose in late mandavastha or early pachyavanavastha, then you can reduce the stage of the mandavastha pachyavanavastha and directly it causes the early pakvavastha, so you can drain out that abscess and the sotha, so if the patient have get early treatment and with less difficulties, discomforts. Next is the patan karma, that is the incision and drainage, and the sodhana is means that as the term mentioned is self explanatory. Sodhana means the cleaning of the tissue, that is the debridement, that with the you may do the medical debridement or the chemical debridement, any kind of the debridement is cleaning of the wound. And next the ropana means the healing. All are the methods which are giving the better environment in that area, that that wound to heal quickly, so that all that the drugs or that any methods that also comes into the ropana karma. Okay. And seventh is abhikatapaha, means wherever there is a in Ayurveda, when there is a vran, there must be a vran vastu, that is a scar. So abhikatapaha means the treatment of that scar. So it looks cosmetically good, and it has not any to reduce the complications. You know that scar also looks ugly, so you can improve that scar, that disfigurement. So these are the seven methods of that management of that sopa. You can choose the management according to the present of their disease. Suppose if you get the any sopa in the mandavastha, first you apply that vimlapana and avsechana. If you get any soap in the pachyamanavastha, you get the upanaha and it get pakvavas, then you can give the patana, sodhana and ropana kriya. If you get any sofa which is patana kriya already done, then you have to do a sodhana and ropana and abhikatapaha. Okay, so these are the stages you have to choose according to the stage, presenting stage of that patients. It is not possible that you get every patient in the mandavastha. Okay, it is possible that you get the patient in the pakvavastha also. So you have to choose the treatment according to the conditions. Next, Susuta mentioned if what should be the fate of that any sofa if we get no treatment in the it not getting the correct treatment at the correct time. So he says, ama chede mas sira snayu sandhya asti vyapadanam ati matram shunita tatye vedana pradurbhava udaranam aneko patro darshanam chatitita. Means if means it is not a correct to always do the patan kriya in that means it is do it is correct if you're doing patan kriya in pakva avastha after shobha. So you do patan kriya, then shodhana, and then ropana. Okay, and then vikatapa. So what happened if any surgeon did that patan kriya in arm shobha, which sofa is not pakva avastha, in amavastha, in pacha manavastha, then what will be happen if you if any do the any surgeon did the chedana or patan kriya in the ama sofa, then he or she may damage the mans sira snayu sandhya sthivya. Means that there is a complication developed due to damaging of that nearby mans sira snayu and sandhi. So there is so much complications. Ati matram shunit pravritti means there is the excessive bleeding may be there. Vedana pradurbhav, excessive pain is there, and anek upadrava darshanam, and so many complications may be present if somebody is giving incision in a apakva sofa, and that condition, the sofa condition may present as a chataj vidhiti. Means just like that wound become chronic. Chataj vidhiti is that whenever there is a vidhiti present in any trauma and any wound, means any wound if get infected, then it is called as chataj vidhiti. Okay, so here that's he also Sushruta said, if somebody get that IND in any sofa, any apsis which is not pakva avastha, in ama avastha and pachamavastha, then that wound become chronic, and there may be severe bleeding, there may be severe pain, and he can damage the nearby the structures, the mansa sira snayu. So either complication it presents. So this is the one incorrect thing. So next thing Sushruta says, if somebody has not giving the incision in the pakvavs, then what happens? There is two chances of the mistake. Now, one mistake here, you are giving the incision in a apakvavastha, and the other mistake that may present, if somebody is not, some doctor is not giving incision in a pakvavastha, then what happens? Sa yada bhaya moha bhyam pakvam apakvam iti manmanyaha manmanishchira subchete upechate vyadhi vaidyastada gambhira anugato dwar malabhana puyaha swam asrayam avadari utsangaha mahant avakasham katva nadi janitya krishna sadho bhochate. Means if any doctor, any it not irrespective of any cause, either he is not able to diagnose the correct condition, that he diagnosed that pakva sofa as a pachyamana amavastha, and he has not giving that patan kriya and shodhana ropan kriya. So that whatever the dosha is there, whatever the pui is there, is collected, it goes deep in the tissue, and it develops that nadi prana, means it develops the sinuses, which may damage to some other nearby structures, and it may travel to the near deeper planes, and the one sinus may develop as the later on it may develop that multiple sinuses, and the fistulas may be there. Okay, so simple, if any abscess you are not bringing in, so whatever the pus is collected, it always finds its base. So wherever in the tissue plane it gets access, it gets deeper and deeper, and infection spreads in the nearby structures. Okay, so reason may be the either bhaya, moha, whatever there maybe ignorance, or maybe not correct diagnosis, any region. Okay, so if any pakva sota is not get the that patan kriya shodhan and ropad kriya at that time, then it may develop that nadi pada. Okay, so here we are concluding that any pakko sofa has what should be principle of management. आद्य अपनम कुरिया द्वितीय उसेचनम तृतीय उपनाह चतुर्थी पाठन क्रिया पंचमम शोधनम कुरिया पंचमम शोधनम कुरिया षष्ठम रोपण मिश्यते एते क्रम बढ़ सकता सप्तम वैकताप. ओके सो देयर आर सेवन टाइप ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट व्हिच शुड बी एडवाइज टू द पेशेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू द स्टेज एंड इफ एनीबॉडी कीप द इंसिजन टू द अपक्व सोफा देन देयर इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द छतज वृद्धि एंड if somebody is ignoring the pakva avastha then there is development of the nadi gran. Okay, so here we are concluding our lectures and that sofa, especially the brand sofa, this is the brand sofa, so this that next lecture we discuss any other things, just like maybe it's modern correlation inflammation. Okay, so this is the Ayurvedic portion, so today we stop our lecture here. Thank you very much.